Welcome back to my channel. I am Sahil and we were learning PHP object oriented programming concept, and this is the ninth video of this series. In previous videos you have already seen some videos on PHP object oriented programming concept like class and objects, constructor, destructor, function, inheritance, interface, abstract classes, etc. Now today in this video I am going to show you about polymorphism. So before going to see actual coding examples, let's first understand what is polymorphism in object-oriented programming. The word polymorphism means many forms. Poly means many and morphism means forms. In object-oriented programming, it deals with functions with the same name but with different behavior. It is implemented using the concept of method overloading and method overriding. But in PHP, method overloading is not directly supported. So in PHP, it is implemented using interface or abstract class. Now, why polymorphism is used? It is used to make the program more elegant and easier to maintain and update. It uses a single function that performs different actions according to the different requirements. Now, to understand polymorphism in better way, let's start coding. So open your code editor. Now here you can see the empty index.php file. Now inside this file, first I will show you how to implement polymorphism using interface. Okay, so let's first create an interface. So for creating an interface, just use interface keyword and then the name of the interface. Okay, now you already know that any interface contains only abstract method. Okay, and abstract methods are not defined, they are only declared. So let's declare an abstract method inside this interface. So just use public function and then function name. So here I will keep calculate area. Okay, now here you can see I have just declared this calculate area function inside this interface. Okay, now to use this function calculate area, we have to create another class and that class will inherit this interface. Okay, so let's create another class circle. Now this circle class will implement this interface. Okay, so here we have to write implements, then just write the name of interface shape. Okay, now we can access this calculate area method inside this circle class, and here we can define this method too. Okay, but before going to define this calculate area method inside this circle class, first I will declare some member variable for this circle class like radius. Okay, now I will also define a constructor method for this circle class. So public function construct. Okay, now here I will pass one argument $r. Now using this keyword I will access this radius member variable, and using this $r argument I will initialize the value of this member variable radius. Okay, now let's define this calculate area method inside circle class. Okay, so to define, here I will simply calculate the area of circle. Okay, so here just write area of circle equal to, now the formula of area of circle is pi r square. Okay, so here I will use pi inbuilt PHP function that will return the value of pi, and then asterisk, then this radius into this keyword and again radius. Okay, here I will concatenate this using br tag for line break. Now create another class rect rectangle implements shape. Okay, now inside this class, first I will declare some member variable like private height, private dollar width. Okay, now constructor method, public function construct, and then dollar h dollar w. Okay, now using this keyword I will assign height value using dollar h into this member variable height. Okay, now width equal to dollar w. Now again I will define the calculate area method inside this rectangle class. So just now this time I will calculate the area of rectangle, and I will use echo here area of rectangle equal to dot. Now the formula of calculating area of rectangle is height into width. Okay, so here just use this keyword and then height asterisk this width. Okay, now again concatenate, use br for line break. Now here you can see I have created two class, one circle and another is rectangle, and both the classes are implementing the same interface, that is shape, and this shape contains one abstract method, that is calculate area. And in circle class you can see I have defined this calculate area method, and in rectangle class also I have defined this calculate area method. Okay, but in circle class this calculate area is displaying the area of circle, and in rectangle class this calculate area is displaying the area of rectangle. Okay, so now let's create an object of circle class, circle equal to new circle. Okay, now here you can see in circle class I have defined a constructor method that I have declared one argument dollar $r for this radius. Okay, so we have to pass one value here for radius. So here I am just passing 5. Now create another object for rectangle. So here I will write dollar rect equal to new rectangle. Now this rectangle class has also constructor method that is taking two argument dollar $h and dollar $w. So let's change for height and 24 width. Okay, now using this circle object I will call this calculate area method, and using this rect object I will again call the same method calculate area. Now just save this, go to the browser and refresh. Now here you can see the area of circle is this and area of rectangle is this. Okay, so we are getting the area of both the shape circle and rectangle using the same function calculate area. Okay, now by this way we can create another class, as many class, and use the same calculate area function to calculate any other shapes area by implementing this interface. Okay, so let's create another class like class triangle implements shape. Okay, now this triangle class will also contain some member variable like private dollar base and private dollar height. Okay, Now I will create one constructor method. Constructor, now here $b $h. Now using this keyword I will assign value in base member variable and this keyword and height equal to $h. Now again I will define the calculate area method inside the triangle class also to display the area of triangle. So here I will use echo and area of triangle equal to dot. Now the formula for calculating area of triangle is half into base into height. Okay, so for this here I will use this and base into this height. Now I will divide it by 2. Okay, now here you can see I have created one more class triangle, and this triangle class is also implementing the same interface, and we are just accessing the same calculate area method and calculating the area of triangle. Now just create another object for triangle, tri equal to new triangle, and here just pass two values for base and height. So here I am passing 10 as base and height for 30. Okay, now just using try we will call the calculate area method again. Now just go to the browser and refresh. Now here you can see area of triangle equal to 150. So by this way you can achieve polymorphism using interface in PHP. Okay, you can also use abstract class to implement polymorphism. So how to do this by abstract class, let's see. So here you have to just create an abstract class. Okay, abstract class shape, and this abstract class also contains abstract method or non-abstract method. So here we have to specify the abstract keyword before the function name. This is an abstract class, so we have to extend this class by the child class. Okay, so here we have to use extends keyword, not implement. Implements is used for interface, but for class we have to use extends keyword. Okay, so just use extend here, and here also just use extends, and in triangle class also just use extends. Now if we save this and go to the browser and refresh, then here there is no error and still displaying all the all the area of shapes. Okay, so this is by abstract class. Now in PHP the method overloading is not supported by just defining the same function inside a class, but we can achieve by using some magic methods, but I'm not going to show here. So you can just achieve polymorphism using interface or abstract class. Okay, now let's see an example of method overriding. Okay, so for this I will create another file test.php. now here let's create a class like base. Okay, base class. Now inside this base class I will create a public function hello. Okay, Now this hello will just display a message like this is base class. This is base class. Okay. Now let's create another class. Class child extends base. Okay. Now inside this class, I will again define the same method hello and change the content here like this is child class. Okay. Now here you can see I am extending the method of this base class inside this child class. Okay, and the name of the method is same. You can see here also the method name is hello and here also hello. Okay, now if we create object of base class $b equal to new base and $c equal to new child. Okay, and if we call the method $b hello and $c hello, and if we go to the browser and just change the URL test.php, then here you can see this is base class and this is child class. Just use echo br tag for line break. Now just save and go to the browser. Now here you can see this is base class and this is child class. So this is an example of method overriding. We are just overrided the same method that is already created in the base class. Okay, here you can see in the child class. But you can restrict the access of this method in child class by using a keyword final just before the function. Okay, so if we just use final keyword here and let's go to the browser and refresh, then here you can see cannot override final method. Okay, so here I have used final keyword, so this function is no longer accessible in the child class. Okay, you can also use final just before the class name to restrict for extending in child class. Okay, so just save and go to the browser, and if we refresh, then here we are getting an error, class child may not inherit from final class. Okay, because this class become final class and we cannot extend this class in any child class. Okay, so this is all about polymorphism. So I hope you liked this video. If you like this video, then hit on like button and please subscribe my channel, and thanks for